Okay. In 1980, Dennis Cohen had an exhibition called 5x5 at his gallery in Auckland, and I was one of the five artists involved. The other artists were Bronwyn Cornish, and Bronwyn was very influenced by the American West Coast movement. Peter Hawksby, similarly, the American West Coast movement, and Warren Tippett, who was experimenting with the use of low-fired earthenware, which was quite new in its time. The artist was Dennis O'Connor, who made work that was also very referencing the American West Coast. And this was my piece. I just returned from the Royal College of Art in London, and so I was full of using ceramic stains and things like that. And from this exhibition, I was asked to curate this new 5x5 exhibition of New Conversations with Clay. And I picked five contemporary female artists who were blurring the line between fine art and applied art. And so here are my five people. So this is the work of Kate Fitzharris. And I love Kate's work because of the narrative nature of the groups of pieces. And not that the narratives are ever stated, but there's a kind of an enigmatic quality to them. And what she has tried to do is introduce the element of time. So you've got flowers in different stages of decay. Some of the pieces are unfired clay, and she's using ceramic underglaze stains almost as a watercolorist would. This work is from Tessa Laird. It references very much the kind of Mexican Day of the Dead ceramics. I enjoy the casual nature, the clay sketchiness of the pieces. I also find the ideas behind the titles of the books fascinating. These pieces are from Suji Park. Originally, the pieces were a group of about 20 figures. And then when I was talking to the artist, she thought, wouldn't it be great to hang them upside down? So by hanging them upside down, they take on the quality of cocoons. They could be, if I stand in the middle, they could be like something from a science fiction movie. Once again, there's a narrative. I mean, you don't know what these things are. You don't know what's going to hatch out of them. You don't know whether they're malevolent. And her pieces have been fired, bisque-fired in the traditional sense, and then they've been oversprayed with different layers of car enamel instead of glaze. These pieces are by Louise Reeve. Louise trained as a painter, so her use of clay is to create a three-dimensional canvas on which to paint with oil paint. So the pieces have been made in bisque-fired and then painted with oil paint. And she references other artists, Gauguin, Klimt, in the kind of the foreshortening of the figures. And some pieces, for example, this one is painted to look like clay, which is like clay being painted to look like clay. Fantastic idea. These pieces here are door handles. Very tactile, very quickly formed. They're almost like a very innocent drawing, quick sketch of what a door handle might be like. This piece by Kate, Wind Chimes, as the name suggests. Very high-fired porcelain clay. On strings, some on strings, some on wires, very roughly made, but the overall idea of collectively making up some kind of spectrum of glaze, and of course there's the magical sound.